Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude. You have been warned. Hey guys, gals, welcome to Gaming Theater. I'm your host, James, aka Wade D. McGinnis, and today we'll be taking a look at Sproggiwood from Freehold Games. It is currently $14.99, or your regional equivalent, and it is, how do I put this? It's an indie RPG strategy game with roguelike turn-based mechanics. There's some story to it. It's very story-driven, but it's like there's civilization elements to it. It's procedurally generated. There's classes. There's monsters. It's very. You know what? Let's just play it. I saw this and I'm like, oh my god, it looks amazing. Let's go easy. Ooh, a little stylistic right there. Look at that. Loading. There were once was an island called Clog, where clogheads chased sheep through the fog. They laughed on the double and never made trouble until they met Sproggi of Sprog. Talking sheep, because why not? Look, over here, a cloghead sleeps. Mysterious stranger. Anyway. My work is done. The rest is up to you. Talking sheep, thank you, Raku. By the power you've granted me, I will save my realm. If you say so. Look, the cloghead awakens. Away, away, before it sees you. Hey, you, with the pitchfork. Yes, you, cloghead. Are you surprised to meet a talking sheep? Why don't you take a closer look? Can I play with the controller? No? Okay, hang on. Here we go. It's a sheep. And it's talking. I told you. Now follow me. I want to show you something marvelous. How do I do that? Oh no! A yellow jelly! It's going to eat us. We are doomed! It's hopeless, Kalahig. Let us lie down and accept our fates. Nya! Do I just... I wreck it! You are brave, Clughead. You saved us from that deadly, adorable jelly. Can I go up or down? No? Damn it! Yikes, another jelly! This one is twice as big, twice as cute. And it will die nonetheless, my pitchfork of justice compels. Alright, choose a power to upgrade. Hurl a pitchfork in a direction at an enemy. Hurl a pitchfork backwards. Extra pitchfork backwards. Hurl a pitchfork in each direction. Scare enemies away for 3 turns, 5 turns. Make enemies fight each other for 5 turns. I kinda like the last one. Bumpkin bomb. Plant the bomb in an adjacent space that will explode. Extra bomb nearby. 2 extra bombs nearby. I want to go with this, because that sounds awesome. Clughead, you look wiser now. It's as if you learned something from the experience of fighting those jellies. Take a look at your new power. We just established this. Powers cost stamina. It looks like killing those jellies gave you stamina stars. Oh boy. We are seeing a pattern, my friends. Oh no. What is that? Don't touch it. On second that. Touch it. I'm gonna be over here. You. Sheep's a wiser sheep than you. Touch. Popsicle. Pokes things. Shoots a pillar of flame that deals. Do I want to poke? Or do I want to cause some. Yep. Take a look at your weapon. It burns things. Violently so. How mighty you are to behold, Clughead, a true adventurer. Wait, Clughead, if you walk up to that jelly, it'll bite you again. Can you outsmart it? If you wait a turn, it'll come to you. Click the hourglass or spacebar. Whoa! Yes, you outsmarted a jelly cube, and you taught it a deadly lesson for being so adorable! That's goo on the ground. Oh, it vanishes. Thank God. Look, this is what I want to show you. A mysterious doorway. Looks like a TV. Let's enter it, heedlessly. Because, why not? I'm led by a talking sheep. And for whatever reason, I feel like it should have, like, a Scottish accent. Look, Codhead. Cloghead. We were transported to a wonderful place. The rivers are so blue. The forests are so green. But I must confess something. I fooled you. I am no sheep. No sheep at all. Hark, mortal! I am Sproggi. Dark lord of this realm, begin your life anew as my thrall. For I am your master now. You will spend the remainder of your days in my realm, Sproggi. Toiling as I see fit. Now let us visit the meager peasant village where you live. So you don't succumb to the feelings of despair. I built this quaint farm and cottage for you. Lovely, aren't they? Now, my thrall, it is time to test your mettle. It is time to put you to work. For your first task, you must quell the uprising of a troublesome jelly lord. His name is Big Ick, and he lives at the bottom of a cave called Ikikulu. Big Ick fancies himself something of a social philosopher. Lately, he's been stirring up dissent among the jellies, trying to convince them to organize into solid forms. I will not have it! You must go to Ikikulu and put Big Ick in his place. Sproggi, it is time to do my bidding, Cloghead. Remember what you've learned about defending yourself when I wore that ridiculous sheep costume. Now go. Okay, I'm an errand boy. Alright, that's okay. Alright, can I avoid? Oh, okay. And boop! Well, 20% chance to ignore an attack and you teleport to a random space. Oh, actually, I think that teleport might be a bad idea. I cannot tell. Alright, boop, and ouch! And boop! No, boop! No, boop! Uh-oh. Okay. Leaves are good, my friends. Leaves are good. Oh my god. Oh, we finally got some music going on here. This game's adorable!
You're blessed with restored life. Use it well, my child. Use it well. Ikikulu. Your days of being a kind person and doing good deeds for your family and your villagers and your nation and everyone around you actually is over.
Changes your surroundings and in strange ways. I want to cash that in. I will not have to deal with strangeness. I refuse such things. Uh-oh. Boop! Boop!
Oh, so lucky! Yeah, look at this! Ah, scheiss.
Identity crisis potion is now available in the shop. Okay. Shoots a frost barb that deals 1 to 2 damage and freezes enemies for one turn. Works once per enemy.
Yes! Brilliant! Love it!
Much better. I was like using the mouse and keyboard. I'm like, this is so much easier.
Big X Lair. Let's. There he is! Don't fall his. Poof. Persuasive retort. Gibble 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 gibble.
What happened to my powers? Teleport nearby in days. Vanish into bats. Shoot an arrow in distraction. Hit enemy. Roll back. I guess that. Okay.
Requires level 6.
Alright, that's good. Alright. Attack!
Yes! Yes, my minions of destruction. Yes.
What does this do?
Wow!
That's awesome. Oh, hang on, let's go for normal attacks here. This is like, you're not gonna get weak, man.
Not again. Never again. Boop. Yeah, get wrecked on it. And I.
Oh, wait, what? What are you? The mushroom just ran away. Why was there a mushroom attached to... Never mind.
And there's a magical door. Let's go in the door. Silence the easy opposition.
Am I truly evil, or am I...
You did it. Excellent work, Lockhead.
Go to Ikikulu and...
What's that? Something about a mushroom. Silence! We will get to that in a moment.
First, let us examine the spores. We've come from the Big X Lair. Dinksh. Alright. I would love to be a warrior.
Yes, Clughead.
Your simple, dull civilization is expanding. Now you can send warriors on adventures.
And each time you beat an old dungeon with a new class, you'll loot 1,000 more gold.
Now tell me about this mushroom.
It popped out. A big ick? A new species. Sproggiwood. Oh, yippee-yahoo. Or, I mean, rejoice. Another creature for me to subjugate.
Oh, who am I kidding? No, Dolark, I'm just Sproggi. Little guardian spirit who wants to save his realm from ruin. I'm sorry about all those terrible things I said to you. Let me explain. This is Sprog. My realm. Well, it's not mine, technically. I didn't create it. But I am its guardian spirit. Anyway, Sprog is populated with some wonderful creatures. But there's no order, no community. With enough time, the denizens of Sprog will ravage each other, leave nothing but destruction and chaos in their wake. How can I be certain of this, you ask? You must trust me, Clockhead, for I know things most spirits do not. That's where you come in. I've been spying on or admiring your people for some time. The Clogheads value peace, order, and civility, and you thrive accordingly. So it hit me. The answer to Sprog's problems is civilization. You can bring civilization to Sprog. So you see, Cloghead, this is why I kidnapped, or guided you to Sprog. Now, I'm going to investigate this curious mushroom. In the meantime, meet Spencer Squish. I relocated him here from Ikikalu so that he could help you around the village. Spencer, explain how the Clogheads should spend their gold. I'll be back with news about that mushroom. With all that shiny gold you won fair and square, you can buy things in town. Push. You can buy civic boosts to improve your civilization. Or gear that you find in dungeons. You may have noticed that some dungeon gear dematerializes when you leave a dungeon through a portal. Jumping through the astral plane has its costs. But once you buy gear at the shop, you can keep it for good. Good. You can also buy potions and scrolls you find in dungeons. Once you buy a potion or a scroll, you can take it with you every time you go adventuring. And that, Squish, is that. Wow, this is actually really, really nifty. I like this. I knew I was going to like it. I just didn't think I was going to like it that much. I would love to have my... Ooh. I don't want the blinking... No, not again. Not again. I will take that, though. The flaming shovel of flaming awesomeness. Ish. Apothecary fund. Merchant quarter. I've got... Clergy scoffers. Pottery school. What are those? Who are you? What is going on? Just in time. I have news regarding the mushroom you discovered. It seems a little bugger has been spawning all over the place. Mushrooms are appearing in Ikikalu and... Gotoruku. What's Gotoruku, you ask? Well, it's the Sprog's fabulous dungeons and home of the goat folk. The goat folk can be quite ornery, if you see. Especially their tribe mother, the Gotress. This is what concerns me. She might not take kindly to finding these little mushrooms in her warren. You must go to Kokuturu and deliver this message. Be nice to the mushrooms. Deliver it by any means necessary. In other words, beat them over with my flaming shovel of awesome. I can do that. I can totally do that. I was born with that. Can I not, I can't. Alright. New armor set. Here we go. Poke. Ow! What was that? Alright. Boop. Boop. Yeah, that's actually poison. Let's not touch that, shall we? Does that dissipate? No. No, it doesn't. Okay. Your prayers have been answered with the joy of loot! Why would I not want a flaming sword, Possum? If you gave me a flaming sword, I'm only gonna run around screaming, FLAMING SWORD! And I just did something evil, didn't I? I think I did. I feel like I did. I'm pretty sure I did. Oh, yeah. Hi, buddy. Oh, that's a giant ghost. Oh, God. It died pretty easy, though. Let's use that. There we go. Oh, that's awesome. Vampire sword. Man, I'm just killing... Am I supposed to be killing these mushrooms? Because I am not doing a good deed here, guys. I am just killing these poor things. Alright. Hey, well, maybe they won't kill me? No, they're gonna kill me. Yeah, they're all violent. Why are you so violent? Let's keep... Boosh. 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 I love this! Vampiric sword is awesome! I mean, it would be so much better if it had more damage, but you know what? I'm okay with that. Look at that. I get the health that I get. Well, except for these guys, which get some kind of apes. Oh my god. Hey, they can actually attack each other? Nicely done. Alright. You think he's still down here? Yes. Yes! You do take damage when you touch that wound. Wound, for I was concerned that you would not.
Oh!
I don't think I need any stamina, but thank you.
More loot is always better.
Shoots fireballs in a direction. Huh! Ghost brand sounds so much better. I get more HP, thank you! Look at this, the more I play this game, the more I'm totally digging it. Oh boy. Yep. Nice! I like the fact that the... they're not entirely protected. Damage from another target actually will hurt them. I love that. I feel like you don't see that a lot in games, which is sad. I mean, it's part of the tactic, right? Of... Why not?
You can't see me.
Oh, I guess they can see me now.
Oh, lady! Get wrecked, oh, lady!
I don't think I was supposed to do that, but... that may not have been the thing to do. Just running and just killing her. I wonder if Sproggy's gonna be upset over that. I think you're back, and you're unscathed! Those goats are a handful, aren't they? Yeah, so about that, sort of killed her. I don't think that's supposed to happen. We don't want her to hurt our new mushroom friends. Yeah, but I think it just committed genocide? Back at Justice, did it belong to the Goatress? Well, she was awfully mean to you, and she doesn't have any issue for us inside. Anyway, let's break it open. I'm gonna go feed. How wonderful. Your civilization continues to grow. Now I have some more great news. Since you got out of the Goatur, the mushrooms have grown too. In fact, it seems they evolved their own civilization in such a short amount of time. How splendid! They even have a capital city called Big Tree, planning a visit just now. I'm going to arrange a summit between their leaders and a Cloghead emissary. Oh, and this will be so unexpected, also wonderful. Two civilizations are thriving. I told you I could do it, Rocco. I told you. Oh, ignore that, Cloghead. I will return for now. I'm off to the Big Tree. When you're ready, come look for me on the world map. All right. Is there anything for this dude? Oh, this dude. Nice! Look at this. That's expensive! Oh my god, that's expensive. Wow. That is expensive. Love the fact that I'm actually, like, building a little thing. He's got a little bit over here. He's got a little thing. Let's see, what do we... Can we put down roads and we can put down grass. Let's see. Clay path? Stone path. Ah! Look at that! I
can move that. I don't want to move that.
What did I do?
Okay, let's plop. Let's move it around. Tree looks good there. No, I don't want that. No, I don't. Right there is good, I guess. Right there. This is looking bad. Hey, bridge. That's not where I want that to go. Can I move that? Okay. Move that down. Move. That looks good, I think. Let's move this over here, I guess. That looks good. Let's move this. Good. Don't like where that tree's at. That tree bothers me. There we go. That looks nice. That can go right there. That can go right there. That looks good. That's nice right there. Nice little happy tree. Sorry, I'm having like Bob Vila or whatever. Welcome to my village. I have heroes who will kick your ass for no apparent reason. So we got a trader, we got a field. I can't click back. Damn it. Is this not costing me anything, I guess? Not? It doesn't cost me anything. Alright. That's okay. See, why not? We have a structure right there. Structure right there. Guess that looks good. I don't know. Obviously, I'm not the planning type. That's apparent. Alright, that looks good. Alright. So this has been Sproggiwood. It is a story-driven, procedurally-generated civilization / roguelike, tactical turn-based RPG that is an indie game you can get right now for $14.99 or your regional equivalent. I highly recommend taking a look at this game, guys. This is a fun game. This is actually a really badass game. If they ever got this on, as an iOS game, I would pick this up on iOS just to play with it while I'm at work. I'd play it out and about, just because I feel like it would actually, it lends itself to the mobile, space, and I think it would thrive in the mobile space, to be honest with you guys. Alright guys, as always, catch you next time.
Hey guys, make sure you check out the videos below for more happy fun times. And if you already haven't, hit that subscriber button to let you know when more happy moments are coming to you on my channel. And finally, if you haven't, hit the like button. Gives you chocolate. No, I'm actually lying. Which I could give you chocolate. Chocolate. Mmm.